Hey, Sean Jantz here. I'm gonna do a quick battle plan for Monday, May 4th. I'm gonna do it on /ES, which is the S&P 500 and the other indices that you can find on Nadex. And I'm gonna start here on /ES. And you'll notice that we're already down tonight. We're already down -1.5%. And a lot, you know, you could definitely consider this move already pushing down Sunday night. You can definitely consider this a fundamentals money's kind of selling off. And yes, that you wouldn't be wrong by saying that. But it wasn't too difficult. If you remember the trade plan in here, I said, hey, be ready. The daily chart has a lot of room to cycle lower. And that's all the market's doing right now. It's just cycling lower. And so I have been talking a lot about the largest price magnet I have ever seen, 2,700. I'm not necessarily saying we'll hit that tomorrow, Monday. But it does seem like that's where these bears are going to want to try and hunt in the next 2 to 3 trading days. So be prepared for that. I do think 2,700 will definitely be kind of the telltale sign in terms of if 2,700, we get through 2,700, could get, who knows where the bottom could be. Obviously, there is demand here around 24, 2460. And then you got the lows here, but 2,700 is going to be interesting in terms of this will have to hold right in this region here for us to even think about even getting closer back to those highs. Now, I personally don't think we're going to see new highs. I actually think we'll probably dump. And one of the reasons is that you start reading some of these headlines. A lot of people are concerned about the reopening of the economy, and we're going to start seeing more and more ripples and stocks really struggling, companies really struggling, and those are going to be some very negative headlines coming in through the economy. We're also going to get payroll reports in terms of unemployment. It's going to be very negative. So we're going to, in my opinion, I think we're going to have some very, very, very negative headlines, which could absolutely continue to push this market lower. So if you're thinking to yourself, oh, should I get in this market in terms of long-term buying? I would say no. You missed it. If you didn't get here, you missed it. Now you need to wait. I would potentially, I would see till at least we can get back here or here or even into here before you can start, in my opinion, if I were, and this is what I've been telling my family or anyone else that's asking, wait, you cannot be buying here. It's too, you missed it. And I did buy here. Hopefully you watched the trade plans. I said, get your ass in. It was freaking awesome. I actually have taken some profits already because the surge was so high. And since I've taken profits, have some cash now, I will wait to see if I can't retest back into here before I feel really comfortable. I think most people, even anyone on Twitter, any expert, they've never seen this before. So we are in an unprecedented time. The only thing that we can do and we can control is our trade plan and a little bit of technical analysis. That's the only thing in our risk management is what we can control. And so if we go here and as obviously just really quickly, right? Daily chart is pretty much now sitting at equilibrium. So the good news is that we actually still have very, very sound structure. If you move here to the 4-hour chart, you can definitely see the cycle, and this is what I call the bird's eye view. Obviously, this cycle was just insane, massively bullish. Higher highs, higher lows, higher high lows, higher highs. And we're definitely on the 4-hour chart getting pretty severely oversold. The good news is that we're going to be coming into some decent demand here, 2,700. I have a hard time thinking we're not going to be that. We won't see some kind of pops to the upside. Kind of see how these pops work. Pops. I think we'll definitely be able to see that. And you'll be able to catch some of these as long as you're waiting for some good change control. The market starts taking off. As you can see in terms of just the cycle higher, it has a lot of room. So don't be, what I would tell you, I wouldn't just be so quick to sell. Like if it rallies in selling here, that just wouldn't make too much sense to me. Because the market, if it does start rallying, maybe we get a positive headlines. Who knows? I have no freaking clue what the headlines are going to be this week. Maybe they're positive and we surge. So be prepared. Obviously, this market from the 4-hour chart, I'll pinpoint here on a smaller time frame where I'm looking for some sell triggers. So now we move here to the 15-day, 15-minute plot chart. And kind of what I touched on is we actually still have some very sound structure. Okay, and so you can see, obviously, there was that. And this right in here was, if you remember, the longer term 61.8 Fibonacci. We got that, and then we've sold off of it. Pretty cool how that works, right? It works because it's just a self-fulfilling move. Okay, and so now let's, what I always like to do, no more indicators. And so what we're gonna do here is what I like to play the game. What if this market goes higher? And then what if the market goes lower? So let's first talk about if we go higher. Obviously, we have a gap in this market. We have a gap, we have set divergence. And so I wouldn't buy just yet, but the opportunity for this to fill will likely be pretty high. And so you can use that to your advantage. I would wait for a potential strength and breakout first, and then you can try and find some pullbacks. You would use touch brackets, traditional futures, find that pullback, and see if you can't run this market back into value rate low and lock in and trailing for the set Monday POC. As far as my first sell trigger, I wouldn't want to be looking for sell triggers until at least, and even then I don't like it, or I say don't like it. Even then, it's not the greatest level of supply. But at a minimum, if I were to look for sell triggers, I would need to be here. My preferred place would be in there, the dynamic. If it took off from here to here, that would then would be the dynamic plus 1.5. If the market goes lower, we obviously have some demand sitting here around -1, -27, -25-ish. So we can look for potential higher low pops off of those. That's, and I say higher low, I'm gonna be, if I were to buy down there, scalping opportunities, looking for some good change control, popping 5, 7, 8, 9 points, taking profits. Obviously you can see down into here, 2,700. That's gonna be really close to a -2. And so, and that's why I wouldn't just continue to, let's say you buy here, you lose, continues to go lower. And right, you buy, you lose, continues to go lower, you lose. Don't just be rushing to catch this falling knife, because a lot of these bears could be hunting that. I have a hard time. We would need some very, very significant fundamental bears trashing this chart tomorrow for us to see 2,700. But I've been seeing some things that I thought no way could happen, and they've been happening, obviously, this year of 2020. So be mindful of how strong 2,700 magnet is. Session Q is pretty much the exact same. So there's not much new to talk about. It's the same type of process. In terms of plus 0.5s, static plus 0.5s, this would be my favorite one rather than ESs. You can see all of the context there. You got a Tuesday POC, Monday POC, value rate high, dynamic plus one. If it took off from here, that would be the dynamic plus one. Okay, same types of, and then same type of structure to the downside. Slash YM, pretty much identical as well. They're all pretty much setting up the exact same. So not much new to talk about. You can see how clean these lines are in terms of deviation and structure. RTY, actually, I wouldn't say necessarily different. It's pretty much the exact same as well. One thing I do like about RTY is 1200, which is really close to a dynamic -1.5. And there's good structure on 1200. It's a big round number. So this would probably be one of my favorites if these indices were to continue going lower. And this was probably my least favorite market in terms of lines to the upside. So RTY is probably one of my top to the downside, probably my least to the upside. So don't forget, we also have deviations on the three major Forex pairs. We also have deviations in value area on gold futures and crude oil futures. And then this one's empty on the bottom right here for anything else that you want to trade. So make sure that you are taking pictures of all of your trades. Use the four-step trading process. You post the bird's eye view, the worm's eye view. So two separate pictures, bird's eye view, worm's eye view, and then post your trade stamp, which is the third picture in the Trader Tribe, so that you can get feedback from me and from others.